in our quest for wisdom and in our discussion as to how to receive wisdom from God, we found that it is important that we pray for wisdom on a daily basis, and that establishes a routine. It is wise to have a routine, especially when it comes to our spiritual issues in our lives and also to constructing the successes for our lives. The Bible says in chapter number 1, verse 6 of 2 Peter, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue, add to your virtue knowledge, add to your knowledge temperance. And so there is definitely a position where we have to add to. So we add onto our current wisdom a greater wisdom, and we do that by seeking. Wisdom comes through learning. Wisdom comes through hearing. Wisdom comes through being taught. Wisdom comes through having the gift imparted into your life. Proverbs chapter number 1 verse 7 says, "The fear of the Lord is the beginning of all knowledge." The fear of the Lord in Proverbs chapter number 9 verse 10 is the beginning of wisdom. That's respect and knowledge of who God is. Simply meaning, we understand that God's principles and God's precepts, God's concepts are so much higher than ours. And when we reverence that and we respect that, then we open our heart, our spirit, to receive the kind of wisdom from God. In this session, we're going to look at wisdom being the principal thing and look at a number of laws through which wisdom functions in. And so the scripture says in Proverbs chapter number 4 and verse 7, wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom. Which means that it's something that you can get. Wisdom is something that you can attain. Wisdom is something that you can reach for. It's not something that's a lifelong quest, something that is so unreachable, something that's just for a handful of people, something that's just for the privileged, something that's just for those that have been to school, something that's just for a group of people in a certain social strata or a certain hemisphere. Wisdom is available to every human being, no matter where they are, no matter what kind of position in life they are. Wisdom is available for every person. Proverbs chapter number 3 and verse 13 says, "Happy is the man that finds wisdom." So in Proverbs 4:7, as we get wisdom, it means that once we seek it to get it, we will find it. And when we find it, it produces a chain, a process of levels of happiness and pleasure. And so happy is the man that finds wisdom. And so for every person that's seeking wisdom, you will find it. And so here are some things we're going to talk about in wisdom. Number one, for all the chaos that is in our lives and for every problem that is around our lives, number one, there is wisdom to solve that problem and wisdom to resolve and bring order to the chaos. Number two, the mind and the heart of a man conceives ideas. It is wisdom that will come to you to harvest or to realize those ideas. So your mind and your heart may have an idea. Sometimes it could be way out. I was preaching at our church, New Life Covenant Church in Harare, in the month of February 2014. And I was dealing with the subject of think, which was a 12-week subject on thinking, as a man thinketh in his heart. And I came up with an idea and I said, there might be a young black woman here, just young. You may, as a child, thought about being the first African astronaut to go to, for example, the International Space Station. Don't anybody despise that dream. Don't anybody take it away from you. And somebody in the back began to sob or cry very loudly. And it was a young lady when she was the age of 7. She was now in her late, very late teens, coming into her 20s, who had that dream that one day she'd be the first female black astronaut to go into space. The very fact that she had this idea in her mind and in her heart, wisdom is going to help her realize that idea and harvest that concept, because it is wisdom that forges that path. Number three, wisdom will attract what you respect and honor, because you cannot possess what you criticize. Let me say that again. Wisdom will attract what you respect and honor, because you cannot possess what you criticize. And we find that many times people are critical of certain positions, certain things. We're critical of certain areas of life, critical of people. And when you criticize or you're critical, generally you repel what you're supposed to attract. But it's wisdom that will give you an understanding of what to respect and honor so that you can attract it. Number four, wisdom will create a path for the future, inspiring you to constantly repeat good actions. Wisdom will create a path for the future, inspiring you to constantly repeat good actions. So when you come into something good, when you discover a good thing, wisdom will give you the discipline to keep on pushing on that path to acquire through repeated actions or routine to acquire what is in your destiny. Number five, wisdom brings great reward to your life by aligning you to deal with problems and chaos in your life. Wisdom will identify the chaos in your life. Wisdom will identify the disorder in your life and then give you the means, the premise, the steps, the stages, the processes in which you can deal with the chaos, the disorder, and the problems in your life. Number six, wisdom will guide you to create opportunities for others. And when you create opportunities for others, you create opportunities for yourself. So when you begin to see a problem that a person might have, they might, for example, have a great gift, and they might need to record, for example, like in my case, God has provided for me to record two great men, Tammy and Denford, who will in the future be international features because they're making room for me, and at the same time, I'm making room for them. So number six, wisdom will guide you to create opportunities for others, thus creating opportunities for yourself. Number seven, wisdom will show you when to be generous at unusual times, in unusual ways, opening the way for unusual blessing. Say that again. Wisdom will show you when to be generous at unusual times, in unusual ways, opening the way to unusual blessing. I was jogging, as I like to do. Whenever I have a free time, I try to get it in, hopefully on a daily basis. And it was a Saturday afternoon. It was really hot in Zimbabwe. And I was jogging. There was a young lady sitting under a little makeshift a canvas with a little tuck shop selling sweets. And also she was selling little bits of tomatoes and onions, just a typical little Zimbabwean side of the road market. And she says to me, "Why are you running? And it's so late in the afternoon and it's so hot." I said, "Oh, well, I don't have too much time because I travel a lot. I'm jogging." And then she said to me, "Can you be my dad?" I said, "Well, you don't even know who I am. How can I be your dad?" She said, "Oh, we know you. We know who you are. We know where you live. We watch you on television. We've attended church, and the many things that you teach us inspires us. And I don't have a father. My dad died years ago. Can you be my dad?" And I was so touched and so moved. And I held her hands. And I said, "Sure, I'll be your dad." And then I said to her, "How old are you?" And she said she was 20 years old. She barely looked 12. And then she told me she was doing A-level. And then I recognized that the reason she had this little shop on the side of the road was simply to pay for her education. And so a few days later, I came by and gave her a nice chunk of money. And she took that money and bought her entire a series of books to complete her A-level. And little did I know that she has a relative in an office in town where we're struggling to get a document signed, and she just put a good word in for us. So the principle is simply this. Wisdom will cause you to open doors for other people when you're generous, and that creates unusual blessing in your life. And finally for this session, God's word is the center of wisdom in our lives. The Bible says in Proverbs chapter number 1, "If you possess wisdom early, If you possess God's word early, wisdom will grow in your life. It becomes like a mighty tree. Psalm chapter number 1, verse 3 says, When you walk and meditate in the word of the Lord, you will be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. Because wisdom has a way of growing things in your life that you didn't even know you could grow. Wisdom will put branches in your life into places like Joseph, where his tree, planted by a well, his branches went over the wall and fed those, even those that hated him, because wisdom has a way of growing in your life. Wisdom in God's word sometimes starts with a seed, but it will increase in your life. So seek wisdom. Seek wisdom early. Pray for wisdom, that God would increase wisdom in your life. Make opportunities for others so that opportunities will be created for you. I pray that God would give you great wisdom and bless your life significantly and open doors for you phenomenally. Like the two men that are serving me today in this recording, I pray that God would give them the opportunities that they've given me. May God bless you. I'm Bishop Tudor Bismark from Harare, Zimbabwe, pastor of New Life Covenant Church.